What's this?
Oh, that. It's a mirror. Actually, it's a telescope mirror lens.
Wow. That's the kind of lens evil geniuses use to take over the world.
You're actually not an evil genius, Eric. You're just a grumpy old genius. And today, this mirror is going to be used for good, to explain to people the importance of social distancing.
Going to use Schlieren photography?
That's right. We're going to use the Schlieren photography setup.
Tiny differences in diffraction of hot and cold air visualized.
Yeah, so let's show the audience the setup. This is our camera, pointed at our mirror, 178 inches away, or 14.83333 feet, which is twice the focal length of that particular mirror. Let's take a look at the front of this setup. This is our setup. Now we start with a point light source. In our case, there's an LED placed behind a block of wood with a hole drilled in it. Now that hole is drilled out larger in the back end than it is in the front end because we want that light to narrow down to a point source. We also put a piece of tin foil over it and put a hole in the tin foil that was even smaller than the second hole. So let's turn on the light and you'll see how it reflects from the mirror and into the lens on the camera. Next, we split the light with a razor blade before it gets into the lens. You can see that here. If I block out the light, you can see where it disappears. Cold air is more dense than warm air, so if I put something cold in front of this, you'll see it drop down. Warm air is less dense, so if I hit it with some sort of a flame, you'll see air rise up. And suddenly, we can see air. We can see the tremendous breath from the massive chest of our scientist. Eric, turn that off.
Idiot.
Okay, so it's just the air from a heat gun. We can also see the turbulent air created from lighting a candle with an Amen flame. Or the heat generated from rubbing our hands together. Or perhaps the high density air falling from an ice sphere. Or better yet, fire and ice, the low density air of a flame rising above the falling high density air from an ice sphere. So how does this relate to COVID-19? In 2008 and 2009, researchers used Schlieren photography to map a human cough. This research helped determine that an average cough can travel 6 feet and expel 2 liters of air in under a second. In the wake of the recent COVID-19 pandemic, the 6-foot social distancing standard is not arbitrary. It has been researched, calculated, and measured. Observe the turbulence coming from the top right-hand section of the mirror. It is coming from a cough several feet away. Look at the violent stream coming from the next cough, which is even closer.
and now a breath and a cough from within the radius of the mirror. And another one from the left-hand side. Remember these images when you practice social distancing. They just might save your life, or that of somebody you love.
So, Eric, what do you think?
I think you need a haircut.
The city's in lockdown, Eric. There are no barbers open. Social distancing?
Well, then practice your social distancing and fix me a pizza.
Say goodnight, Eric.